The next device is thyristor. It is also known as silicon controlled rectifier, okay, SCR. So it is a 4-layer, 3-terminal and 3-junction device. Okay, in some bits or any questions you might be asked, SCR is a dash terminal device, like in multiple choice. It is very simple, but you might get somewhere. So okay, this is a 4-layer, 3-terminal and 3-junction device. So the current through SCR depends on load, not rated current. In any case, if you take any electrical device, the current is going to flow depending on the load connected. If there is no load, there is no current through the device, right? So that's what here I'm saying. Okay, and there are basically various stages for an SCR, that is turn on, turn off, or before turn on, it is forward blockening stage. So as I said, there are 3 junctions, J1, J2 and J3. So initially, during forward blockening stage, where there is forward leakage current, the junctions J1 and J3 are forward biased and J2 is reverse bias. So for the device to turn on or to allow the current, all 3 junctions should be forward biased, right? So when J1, J3 are forward biased and J2 is reverse biased, only there is little bit current, which is known as forward leakage current. So here you can see the characteristics of thyristor or SCR. So there I have written forward leakage current, that is during forward blockening stage. Then when you apply gate signal, it is going to get turned on. Okay, so depending upon the applied gate current, the block over voltage of the thyristor depends. Means the gate current is IG3, which is less than IG2, the VBO will be more, as I have shown there. Similarly, if you increase the gate current from IG3 to IG2, the VBO will reduce. That's why the curve is coming towards the left side. Okay, similarly, if you apply IG1, it is still comes to left side. Okay, that is in the positive half side. So now in case of reverse, there in third quadrant I have mentioned reverse voltage drop. Okay, similarly, if there is load, the characteristic is just beside, it is going to become just beside y-axis, and if there is no load, it is far from the y-axis. Okay, and the point is reverse breakover voltage, as I mentioned there, VBR. Okay, right. So how to turn on the SCR, that we will see now. Triggering mechanisms for turning on SCR. So out of them, the important triggering methods are, one is gate triggering and another one is dv by dt triggering. Okay, so first of all, what is meant by turning on of SCR? So turning on of SCR means bringing SCR from forward blockening to forward conduction stage. Okay, similarly, what is meant by turn off of SCR? So it is nothing but bringing SCR from forward conduction to forward blockening again. Okay, just reverse to the turn off. Okay, so, and one important point is that thyristors conduct for both AC or DC. You just need to give some gate current for turning on in case of gate triggering. So here, if you observe, in case of gate triggering, I have drawn a plot there between VA and IG, where VA is anode voltage, okay, or the voltage across the anode and cathode of SCR. So, and the x-axis is IG. As you increase the gate current, what's happening to the anode voltage, means anode voltage requirement, the anode voltage requirement to turn on the SCR is getting reduced. Are you getting my point? If you gradually increase the gate current supplying through the gate of the SCR, the anode voltage that is required to turn on the SCR is going to get reduced. That you can see from that figure, and that I have mentioned with the relation VA is proportional to 1 by IG, that means inversely related to the gate current. And there I have mentioned the finger voltage, that is the minimum forward voltage, that is minimum voltage across the anode or the SCR required to turn on the device for any IG. Okay, for any IG, right? Then the second method of triggering is dV by dt. So here in this triggering method, there are two important capacitance terms. They are nothing but transition capacitance and diffusion capacitance. So here transition capacitance occurs during reverse bias, okay. Similarly, during forward bias, diffusion capacitance occurs. So how to remember it easily? If you observe there, I have mentioned I circled R and T, and in between I mentioned S. That means for reverse bias, it is transition capacitance. The shortcut is that in between R and T there is S, okay. R S T P Q R S T, right? So if it is reverse bias, R S T transition, that's it. That's how you can easily remember. Similarly, it applies during forward bias also, that is D E F, A B C D E F. So diffusion capacitance is during E F, F is forward bias, okay, that's it. And but one disadvantage of this triggering is uncontrolled conduction. So suppose if you increase the rate of change of voltage across the device, the conduction may not be controlled, okay, right? So in the next lecture we will see the latching current and holding current. Thank you.